Hello everyone, welcome back to Pantech e-learning channel. This is our Divyanjali from Pantech e-learning. Today's webinar is under the caption Artificial Intelligence. So Pantech is one of the very best platform where we can experience, innovate and implement different technological works. So coming to the today's webinar is under the caption Artificial Intelligence. This webinar is being conducted by Karpagam Academy of Higher Education, the Department of Bachelors of Computer Applications. The convener of the event is Dr. R. Gunasundari Ma'am, HOD of BCA. So on behalf of Karpagam Academy of Higher Education, I welcome all the participants to this webinar. Coming to the overview of Pantech e-learning. So Pantech was first established in 2004 with 7 wings with hire of 100 plus team size and industrial and design service laboratory, equipment manufacturer working on funded projects, that is research and development works are going on in this Pantech e-learning. Services, different services that Pantech is providing like workshops, faculty development programs, internships, value added courses, online training, project guidance, and also training of nearly 2000 plus workshops have been conducted by Pantech e-learning with 300 plus faculty development programs all over India, and also 12.5 lakh students all have been participated in such events. Coming to today's webinar, so that is the concept of artificial intelligence technology. You might have already heard about this word at least till now, artificial intelligence, right? What is this artificial intelligence technology? As day by day everything is improving in the technological market, in the social market, so technology is being growing on very rapidly, right? So this artificial intelligence is something very new and very something improving and very something we can call it as rapidly changing the society. What is this artificial intelligence technology? So it is a branch of computer science, so that can deal with simulation of intelligent behavior in computers, or also the ability of a machine to imitate the intelligent human behavior. Imitate means what? So copy. So to behave as our human brain, how it is been responding, it should have the ability, the computer or the machine should have that ability to imitate the intelligent of human behavior. So it can not only support human work or decision making process, but could eventually replace them. So this AI is first the field that threatens to compete with humanity in a domain long considered to be unreachable for machines. So that is making the intelligent decisions. So in simple words, artificial intelligence can be defined as inserting a human brain intelligence system into a computer so that the computer will have the ability or it will have the capability to work as fast as our human brain responding. Do you know how our human brain responds? So with neuron connection, so the data will be processed within fraction of seconds, right? So for each and every situation, it will be processing the data within fraction of seconds. It will respond according to the situation, according to what the situation is facing by the human brain responds. How twisty is it, right? How, what we can say, how miracle it is actually. So in the same way, the system should have the ability to work as spontaneous as it is, it should respond to the all the inputs whatever we are giving to the system. So this artificial intelligence is the science of building intelligent machines from a very large volumes of data and learning from experiences to perform the human like task. So to perform however human performs the task, the same way the system also should perform the task whatever it has been assigned. So it is nothing but artificial intelligence. Moving on to the next slide. Yes, here in this session we will be discussing about these concepts. First we'll move on to the introduction to artificial intelligence, and next we'll move on to types, what are the different types of artificial intelligence technologies we are having. Next, we'll move on to what is an agent, agent concept, right? Then followed by types of agent, what are the different types of agents we are having, why we are moving on to this concept agent, what is so special about this concept. Next, we'll move on to the platforms in artificial intelligence. What are the different platforms we are having in this technology, artificial intelligence technology. Then after that, I'll be concluding the session. So as this is the very start of the session, I request everyone, if you are having any doubt at any point of the session, you can please comment in the comment box or comment session about your doubt. So the last 5 minutes of our session or in the middle of our session, we can have the time to get back to the comments, and we will be having such questions. If you are having any type of question, you please put a message in comment box so that I can get back to you, okay? So moving on to the introduction to artificial intelligence technology. So I have already defined it. It is nothing in simple words can be defined as inserting a human brain intelligence system into a computer or into a system so that it will have the ability or it will have the capability to work as fast as our human brain responding. So in today's world, the technology is very rapidly growing. So we are getting in touch with very, very new technologies like different languages, different technologies, artificial intelligence, machine learning, deep learning, data science, number of technologies have been coming on. So what are all these technologies representing? So that is what we are going to see in today's session about this technology, that is artificial intelligence. The future is no longer a time frame. Yes, so as time is very important, it is very rapidly, very important. Every second changes the time, changes the environment, changes the concepts, changes the technology. Everything going on changing within seconds, right? So the future is a mindset. So it is nothing but now the future became whatever we think in the mind. It will be applied in real-time applications that we are going to have in future. So we are doing whatever we are going to implement in future, that we are doing whatever, whenever we get that idea, we implement suddenly by using all the technologies, whatever we are implementing. So we can use them and we can real-time applications, we can implement them. So that is nothing but the future is our in our mindset. So whatever we think, we have to do. So AI is one of the fascinating and universal fields of computer science, which has a very great scope in future. Yes, it has a very, very great scope in future. I'm telling you now only, whoever is attending today's session, whoever is having the basic knowledge of artificial intelligence technology, if you are really interested to work in this technology, know about this technology, work, start working from your student age itself, then only you can learn on and you can do some research work and you can find what are the different things going on under this technology, what are the researches going on, everything. Concentrate on this technology if you are really interested to work, if you are willing to work. So it will really give you a very great future. So the future totally will be surrounding with AI technology. So it is having a very, very great scope. Moving on to the next slide. Yes, humanity will change more in the next 20 years than in the previous 300 years. Whatever we have learned, whatever it is, it's been there, it's been started since 300 years, what we are implementing, it's no longer been now. So within 20 years, we can change everything. So science fiction is becoming science fact. Imagination and foresight are now mission critical. This artificial intelligence is composed of two words, artificial and intelligence. So where artificial defines man-made, so we are made, so that is man-made, and the intelligence defines thinking power, how we think, how we are implementing, what is the thinking capability, that is nothing but the thinking power. Hence this AI means a man-made thinking power. Whatever the we are thinking, so that is the man-made thinking power. We are creating this intelligent system, right? Yes. So if you can see, we already know the history, so how a mankind has been started, and how we have started learning. So from the age of previous history years, we have been started, we have been walking, and we have been seeing and understanding the data. Now at this present situation, so it is becoming very technological. Our mind is really very fast, so it can respond spontaneously, right? Yes, you can see here. So top Python machine learning libraries. So what are the different libraries we are having? So these are all the different library files. So some of them are here, which you can see on the screen now. NumPy library file, SciPy, Scikit library file, Theano, TensorFlow, Keras, Pandas, Matplot library. Among these five library files are most important. Most important in machine learning. What are those library files? NumPy. Coming to this NumPy library file, it is used for numerical values accessing purpose. To work with the numerical data, to access any numerical data, we will be using this NumPy library file. Next is Pandas library file. So Pandas library file is used for data accessing purpose. To work with the data, to access any data, we will be using this Pandas library file. Whatever the input data we want, if we wanted to access it, so we will be using this Pandas library file to work with our input data. Next is Matplot library file. Matplot library file, the word itself describes the Matplot library, right? So what is this library file especially we are using for? Visualization of data. Why we have to visualize the data? Already we will be having certain input, right? So why we have to visualize? Because the system can understand the data in a graphical format, in a simple way. So the graphical data can be easily grasped by the system. That's why we will be visualizing the data, input data, in a graphical format, and that is done by using this Matplot library. Next is Seaborn library file, that is used for customization purpose in the graph. And here you can see TensorFlow and Keras. So those are used in deep learning. So we will be using a neural network connection we will be using. So the Internet of Things is the new nervous system. So it is nothing but we are working with machine learning with IoT, right? So how it's been processing the data, how it's going to illustrate as the data, society is been changing, technology is been improving. So we are going to implement, this is the current trend, machine learning with IoT. So this is also to be focused. So coming to the history of artificial intelligence technology. So what is this history? When has it been started? What is so special about these years, about all these years? What has been improvised in all these years? That is what we would like to get back in this slide. So since 1950, so that the term artificial intelligence have been started. So Alan Turing, so he was a person who did this Turing test in 1950. This Turing test is basically determines whether or not a computer can determine a, or it can think intelligently like a human. So it is the test whether it is proving that we would like to know. We are giving testing like, so whether a computer can determine and can think intelligently like a human or not. That is what this Turing stage is. So next is coming to 1951. It is used for game artificial intelligence. So we can allot, so here we have allotted a computer develops programs for game development purpose in 1951. Whereas in 1951, AI has born. So the term artificial intelligence, it was being coined by computer scientist John McCarthy to describe the science and engineering of making intelligent machines. So he was the person in 1955 to 1956. He was a person, John McCarthy. He was the first person to coin the term artificial intelligence at the Dartmouth conference. So coming to 1959, see, this MIT AI laboratory was set up in this year 1959. Okay, so the research on AI has began from this 1959. So in 1960, General Motors robot, it was the first time the first robot was introduced in to General Motors assembly line. So in 1961, AI first chatbot called Eliza was introduced. And in 1964, Eliza was introduced, right? In 1966, Shaake, the first electronic person from Stanford, Shaake, is a general purpose mobile robot that reasons about its own actions. So now in 1997, IBM's Deep Blue beats world champion Garry Kasparov in the game of chess. In 1998, so MIT introduces Kismet, an emotionally intelligent robot, insofar as it detects and responds to people's feelings. And after that, it has been very rapidly improvising in all these years, 1999, 2002, 2011. So this Avo, Romba, Siri, you know this Siri, right? So it is nothing but an AI only. So you might have seen in movies also. And Watson, Eugene, Alexa, Tay, AlphaGo, these are all very rapidly improving. And till now, this is all about the history of artificial intelligence technology. So why we are moving on to this artificial intelligence technology? What is so special about this technology? Number of technologies are there. What is so special about this technology? So with the help of AI, you can create such softwares or devices which can solve real world problems very easily with highest accuracy, such as not only in one or two domains, but also in different domains like health issues, marketing, financial, tours and travels, traffic issues, in everything. It's been very important, very rapidly improvising. With the help of this AI, we can create our personal virtual assistant, such as Cortana, Google Assistant, Siri, different like this, right? So with the help of this AI, we can build such robots which can work in an environment where survival of humans can be at risk. AI opens a path for other new technologies, new devices, and new opportunities also. Moving on to the goals of this artificial intelligence technology. Replicate human intelligence is in the sense, it should be copy-paste, right? How our human brain responds, how the system responds, it should be replicated, directly proportional. It should be same. There should not be any change. The aim is this only. The aim of artificial intelligence is to make the system respond as fast as our human brain responds. So to solve knowledge intensive tasks, even the human brain cannot answer. So such complex data also, artificial intelligence has to be working on the task. An intelligent connection of perception and action. So for each perceptions and actions of different actions, tasks, it has to perform very intelligently. Building a machine which can perform tasks that requires human intelligence system. So we have to build a machine that can perform tasks that requires human intelligence. As however human intelligence works, in the same way a machine also should work. So creating some system which can exhibit intelligent behavior, learn new things by itself, demonstrate, explain, and can advise to its user. Whoever it is using, according to the user, it has to create its environment, it has to develop by each and every day. Here you can see Project Speech Emotion Recognition. It is nothing but recognition system, right? So speech signals, how it will be analyzed emotions, whether we are happy, angry, sad, surprised, all these are emotion recognition, right? How it can be recognized by actually humans, we can recognize. Now it should be analyzed by a system based on how we are speaking. It has to respond in the same way how our emotions are. So that recognition is possible. So it is being done in Python programming also. We have done this project. So we have to still develop. So in machine learning, in deep learning, how we can access the data, how we can recognize this type of emotion recognition. So that is also one of the important concepts. So what comprises to this artificial intelligence? So philosophy, computer science, psychology, neuron science, biology, mathematics, sociology, these are nothing but different areas where artificial intelligence has a very great importance now in the today's market. So in all these areas, artificial intelligence have a very great usage to improve to a great extent. Moving on to different applications of artificial intelligence. Online advertising. Yes, so how our advertisements we will be seeing on online. So it will be getting us the related one according to the user, whoever using, according to the account users who are using, according to their interest of usage. So advertisements will be coming. And also that is one of the application of artificial intelligence, personalized user experience. According to the user experience, according to the user needs, it will be suggesting us the data, right? Like products such as shopping, for all that we will be using this artificial intelligence. AI powered chatbot system. So yes, it is also one of the application, very important application actually. Here a chatbot will be, instead of a human, it will be talking with us in a chat, right? So it is asking what is the information, what do you want, so what can I help you, may I know what is your requirement, such type of questions where we'll be getting in online chats, right? So there, that is nothing but online, that is AI chatbot. Okay, next is predictive analysis. To analyze the data in a predictive manner, where to get the calculations in such way, we will be using this predictive analysis applications. Web development. Yes, to design web designing purpose also, in web development purposes also, artificial intelligence has a very great importance. Content generator. How a content can be generated? So based on the needs of the user only it can be generated. Only the suggested ones, only the filtered content will be accessed by the user. So that is nothing but content generator. This is also one of the application of artificial intelligence technology. Content curation. It is nothing but duration. So how it is going to be queued, the content. So that is also one of the application of artificial intelligence technology. Email marketing campaigns. So we will be having number of emails according to the user interest. What are the required emails? So that only it will be accessed. Others will be trashed. Okay. So voice speech optimization. So voice search optimization. Optimization is nothing but modifying or improvising. Okay, now so voice search, according to the voice search, how it's been getting, how it, we can access the data. So that is what we can see in this application, like Google Assistant, like that, right? So through voice only we will be getting whatever the data. YouTube also, if we can speak, it will give us the what are all the related data it is there we will get. And e-commerce, I have already told you, this e-commerce means online shopping, products buying. So all this comes under e-commerce, where it will be illustrating us all of the related or user needed according to the user interest. So that will be suggesting us whether to buy that product or not, like that. So top 5 machine learning trends for 2021 in the present scenario. The intersection of machine learning with IoT. It is one of the important trending technology. So machine learning with IoT, how we can develop the data, how we can process the data, how it's possible. Machine learning is totally related to only system, whereas IoT related with the system with the clouding, right? Cloud computing, how both can be accessed, how, what is the use of machine learning with IoT. So that is all the very important concept now in the present scenario. Automated machine learning. So automated machine, first of all we are discussing machine learning in this technology. What is this machine learning? So I can be simply defined it as a branch of artificial intelligence technology, a subset of artificial intelligence technology. What is this branch? Why it has come into existence? So artificial intelligence technology, the word itself tells us, it is a very huge, very vast technology where it cannot be developed in single day or single year or a single decade. Because it is not a simple task. It needs a very, very long time to come into its existence, to work on the data. So this machine learning, deep learning, data science are the branches of this very vast technology, artificial intelligence technology. So machine learning can be simply defined as a machine or a system which will be learning from past experiences, past data, historical data. Using such data, it will be improvising in the present task or present application. What are some of the features of this artificial intelligence? So it is helpful in decision making, to solve complex problems, to perform high level computational problems, and to increase the accuracy of the prediction. So for all these purposes, we are using this artificial intelligence technology. Okay, next is rise of AI ethics. So what are the ethics of AI? How it's been rising? So this is also one of the trending technique. And one more is machine learning in cyber security. How it's been improving and how it's been important in cyber security. What is so special about this cyber security? How it's been secured, giving us the security. But that is also one of the trending. And AI engineering. So it is also one of the important trend that is nothing but how it's been utilized by the engineering students in engineering field. Moving on to the next. So machine vision is, so it is an application of computer vision which enables a machine to recognize whatever object is. So this machine vision captures and analyzes the visual information. So whatever the data we are having, that will be analyzed in a graphical format. Okay, now, so using one or more video cameras, analog to digital converters, digital signal processing. So with all these help, it can be analyzing the data, image capturing. So machine vision systems are programmed to perform narrowly defined tasks, such as counting objects, reading the serial numbers. So different types of these tasks. Computer systems do not see in the same way as human eyes can see, right? But it is also bounded by human limitations, such as to see through the wall. So within the boundary, it has to be seen. So with the help of this machine learning and machine vision, an AI agent can be able to see the through the walls, through the data, whatever we are having, through the boundary. So in machine learning, we will have different algorithms. Among them, what is this algorithms actually? It's nothing but the flow, however data can be processed. So in this, we will be having different approaches. Among them, we will have different machine learning algorithms. All the algorithms will be seen in three approaches: supervised machine learning approach, unsupervised machine learning approach, reinforcement approach. Under these only we can see this linear regression comes under the supervised approach, where it can be plotted in a linear graph, which you can see here. According to whatever the data we are having, it can be plotted in a linear line, which you can see on the screen. So what is this mean by variance in machine learning? So it is an error from sensitivity to small fluctuations in the training set. So in our input data, we will be dividing to training and testing purpose, that we will be dividing into these two categories. So it is nothing but an error from sensitivity, which is getting through sensitivity. So it is nothing but small fluctuations we can see in the training data set. So here you can see overfitting fluctuations, underfitting fluctuations of our data, whereas good balance, which you can see here. These are the three criteria. Speech recognition. So it is used in speech recognition. It is a way to talk with a computer. How we are talking with a computer? On the what basis? So of that commands. So a computer can perform a specific task. System controls or navigation system. Industrial applications. Voice dialing systems. In all these, artificial intelligence having certain importance. Coming to this, types of artificial intelligence technology. So what are the different types? So based on different categories, we have been classified them. So type 1, type 2. So based on different criterias, we have been classifying our artificial intelligence as type 1 and type 2. What are these type 1 and type 2? So based on different technologies, we have been predictive analysis, we have been differentiated them, right? So narrow artificial intelligence, general artificial intelligence, strong artificial intelligence, reactive machines, limited memory, theory of mind, self-awareness. So these are different types of artificial intelligence technology. So what are all these types representing? What are each and every type of artificial intelligence technology representing? What is so special about these technologies? So that we will be discussing. So this narrow artificial intelligence is nothing but, so you can see type 1, that is narrow artificial intelligence, general artificial intelligence, and super artificial intelligence. What are these artificial intelligence? This narrow artificial intelligence, also known as weak artificial intelligence. So it focuses on one narrow task and cannot perform beyond its limitations. Whatever it's been assigned, whatever the data, whatever the boundary it's been given, till that point of time only, till that point of condition only, it will be working. So it is very widely used for NLP technique. What do you mean by NLP technique? What is this technique illustrating? So it is nothing but natural language processing technique, which is mainly used to access the text data, like sentence data, paragraphs data. For performing like sentimental analysis, we will be using this weak narrow artificial intelligence. So IBM Watson is one of the example of this technology, weak artificial intelligence technology. Moving on to next general artificial intelligence technology, it is also known as strong artificial intelligence technology. It has the ability to understand and learn any intellectual task that a human brain can do. So K computer is one of the example that comes under this technology. Coming to super AI, here it exceeds human intelligence and it can perform any task better than a human. So its existence is still hypothetical. It means it's not yet existed. So it's just theoretically it's present. That's it. Okay. Practical way isn't yet out. Okay. Moving on to the type 2. So here you can see there are mainly 4 types of artificial intelligence technology: reactive machines, limited memory, theory of mind, self-awareness. What are all these type 2 representing? So reactive machine is nothing but it is a basic form of artificial intelligence that works only with the present data but does not have any past memory to process the information. So it works with present task data only. It does not have any past historical data to process any information from that past. So example we can see like IBM Deep Blue. So that comes under this tech. This reactive machines only. Okay, so next coming to limited memory. So artificial intelligence learns from past data to make the decisions. To make any decision, this technology uses the past data. The memory of such systems, which is short-lived, it means within very short time we are having such data, right? So such past data we can retrieve back. Okay now, so by using that data it will be used. So that is nothing but limited memory, within very short time memory, past recent memory only will be present. Such past data only will be present, that only we can access. So example is self-driving cars. Yes, we can drive without our human effort. A self-driving car's existence have been started in all over the world, but not presently in our society. So still we are using human drivers also, but soon we can replace them with just what we can say, automatically driving cars, right? So it can automatically drive without a human needed, human work needed over there. So it can access the data, it will access the data of nearest cars, how speed it's going, where is the traffic signals, whether it is getting green signal or red signal, it based on that it is going to work. So that is the example of this limited memory artificial intelligence technology. Theory of mind. So it exists as a concept. Only as a concept it exists and should be able to understand people's emotions. It should have the ability to understand what are the people's emotions, sentiments and thoughts also. So like Kismet and Sophia, so how they can access, how they can understand our feelings. So it should have that ability. That is nothing but theory of mind AI. Next is self-awareness. What is this self-awareness? So AI only exists hypothetically. So such system understands their internal traits, states and conditions and perceive human emotions. So it can exist, that's it. It is just existed in a theoretical way. So the system also has to understand the internal feelings of a human behavior, how our emotions are changing us. So what is the thing behind the emotion? So it has to understand that. So moving on to agent. What is this agent? What this, how it has come? Before this, let me tell you the domains of artificial intelligence technology. So the domains of artificial intelligence technology includes machine learning, deep learning, robotics, expert systems, fuzzy logics, and NLP technique. Machine learning, I have already told you. So it is nothing but a machine or a system which will be learning from past experiences, past data, historical data. Using such data, it will be improvising in the present task or present application. So here we will be having three approaches like supervised, unsupervised, reinforcement. All the algorithms we can see in this only. Whereas deep learning is nothing but it will be working with neural connections. However, human brain responds with the neuron connection only, right? Neuron connection which is present in our brain. So how it can access the data through neurons, nerves. So in the same way, the data can be accessed in the deep learning, that is through neural networks only. So it can access very fastly, but it will take a lot of time to access the data. Whereas in robotics, so you know that robotics is a branch of artificial intelligence technology which can focus on different branches and applications of robotics. Coming to fuzzy logics, in medicines to solve complex problems in decision making, we can use this fuzzy logics. It is also used in automating gear system in cars, like you can see automatic cars, right? Driving, self-driving. So next is expert systems, an AI based computer systems that can learn and reciprocates the human ability of expert systems. So it will be working on certain condition like if and logic notation. So to solve the complex programs or problems. So for that, now moving on to this agent concept. What is this agent? So it is something that acts or basically that does the same task on the behalf of the some part or some person. It's on behalf of some person, some act is being going on, some task is being going on, that is nothing but an agent. So in artificial intelligence, what is this agent can be defined as? So an agent is not anything that can be viewed as perceiving its environment through the sensors and acting upon that environment through actuators. So sensors and actuators are important. What is this sensors and actuators? So sensor detects the events and changes in environment. It detects whatever events are, and it will be changing in the what in our environment, whatever the environment we are using, in that it will be changing the data. Whereas the actuators are nothing but just movable parts. So it is nothing but the movable parts of agent. So actuators and sensors both are important. Okay, now so for human agents, so we can see here different types of agents like human agent, robotic agent, software agent, sensors, actuators, effectors. Actually, actuators and effectors are means same. Okay, now so whereas sensors, I have already told you, which is used to detect an event and change in the environment. Software agent works only for the software development work, whereas robotic will be used for visualizing data, for accessing data, for that cases. So it can in these sensors can be cameras, infrared ranges, range finders. Actuators can be different movable parts, okay, of motors. So whereas human agents are nothing but here sensors can be called like eyes, ears, and certain organs of our body. We can use it as the human agent sensors, whereas actuators can be hands, legs, like that, okay, now any body parts. So piece representation, what is this? So performance measure, environment, actuator, sensors. So how it is going to process, this is also one agent. How it's been considering means based on the performance, on which environment we are using, what are the actuators and sensors we are having in that, based on that it is been using. So here you can see performance, safety, time, legal, drive, comfort. According to the safety, within the whatever the time that is allocated, it has to drive legally, and comfort zone it has to be. That is what the performance, how it's been calculated. So next is environment. So roads, other vehicles, road signs, pedestrians, all these considered as the environment. Okay, now so actuators and sensors. Actuators like steering, accelerator, brakes, signal, horn, all these are the actuators. Whereas sensors are cameras, GPS, speedometers, odometer, accelerometer, and sonar. So some of the examples of agents with their piece representation, here you can see here medical diagnosis as an agent. Performance can be measured for healthy patient's health and for minimized cost. So based on that two cases, we are going to the environment. Such environment we can see like patient, hospital, and their staff. Coming to the actuators, different actuators like test and treatments are used for medical diagnosis. Sensors can be keyboards or entry of system symptoms. So you can see one more, part picking robot. For this, the performance measure how it can be taken percentage of parts in correct bins. So in perfect percentage we have to take. So what is the environment? Conveyor belt with parts, bins also. Actuators, jointed arms and hands acts as actuators, whereas camera and joint angle sensors act as sensors. Here you can see the self-driving cars without a human need, without a human support. So it can access, it can directly work, right? That is nothing but automatic driving. So moving on to the types of AI agents. So there are mainly four types we can see. So you can see here, human, robot, this is what we have already discussed about human agent, robotic agent, sensors and actuators, right? Types of AI agents, yes. Moving on to these types of AI agents. So we are mainly having four types actually. Simple reflex agent, model based reflex agent, goal based agents, utility based agents, learning agents. This goal based agents comes under model based reflex agents only. Okay, now so we are mainly having four categories: simplex reflex agents, model based agents, goal based agents and utility based agents, and also learning agent also we are having. So what are these reflex agents representing us? So simple reflex agent, so here these are very simple. Here it ignores the percept history, so it will be acting on the current perception. So perception is nothing but a way in which something can understand or interpret. Here you can see, so what we first through actuators, so condition, action rules, right? So what action I should do, so based on this action we will be given to the environment. Now the environment will give to the sensors. So what are the sensors here, what to do, what not to do, how it can be accessed, so how it can be sensors. So that is what we can see. So based on the condition action rule, if the condition is true, action will be taken place, else it won't take place anything. It works only on fully observable environment. So this is how this simplex reflex agent can be performed. Coming to this model based reflex agent, so it can handle partially with observable environments. So here you can see its current state is stored inside the agent, maintaining some kind of structures which describes the part of the world which cannot be seen. So here you can see sensors and actuators are there. So based on the condition whatever we have given, it will be taken to the environment. Here the environment, it will access the actuated data and it will be percepted to the sensors what to do. What are the sensors? Here you can see the state, how the world involves, what may be the actions to do. So what my actions to do, such are all the sensing, how we can sense, right? So this is how the model based reflex agent can perform. This knowledge about how world works, it is called as model based reflex agent. So a model based reflex agent should maintain some sort of internal model. So that depends on the percept history, and also it reflects some of the unobserved aspects of the current state. Okay, now next let us move on to the goal based agents. So it is the improvised version of this model based agent only. It is the expansion of model based agent reflex agent, where it will be based on the desirable situation or desirable goal oriented situation. It will be using in searching and planning of data. Here you can see the actuator, goals will be given. So using the situations, actuators, that actions will be given to the environment. According to the environment, the actions to be followed to the sensor. Percepts is nothing but analyzing and forwarding the data here. Now that actuated data will be percepted to the sensors. Now it will understand whether to do that or not based on the conditions, what sensors we can use, we will be using, how the world evolves and what my actions do based on the different states, how it is going to perform. That is what we will be understanding. Moving on to utility based agent. Here you can see it will be focusing mainly on the utility, not on goals. So you can see here we will be using the how utilizedly we are using the data. So that utility we are taking here, how happy I will be in such a state, that data we are taking, what actions should I do now, that actions we are giving as the actuated data. so that we are giving to an environment. That environment will be followed by the sensors, so that sensors will start analyzing the data, which state of data, what the world is like now. So what it will do, it will be like, if I do this action A, so it will understand what is the utility of doing such work, such data, such processing. Like that it will be understanding in this utility based agent. Moving on to learning agent. So here different components we will be using in this learning agent, like critics, learning element, performance element and problem generator. So these are the different elements we are using here. How we are using? First, the effectors are nothing but actuators. This data will be that actioned data we are giving to the environment that perceives the data to the senses, right? So first of all, what is this agent consisting of different elements? What is these elements representing? Moving on to critics. So what is this critics? It is nothing but the data using the sensors of input specifying effects of any agent action. So on the different environments, which the performance standards and generates the feedback for learning element. So it will be generating the feedback for learning element from this environment. It will be taking the data and it will generate some feedback to the learning element, right? I think everyone is following. If you are having any doubt at any point of your understanding, please put a message in message box or comment box so that I could be answering your questions at the last 5 minutes. So next is learning element. So this learning element, this component is responsible to learn from the difference between the performance standard as well as the feedback from the critics. So it is the difference between these two we will be getting over here, that is the learning element. So according to current percept, so it will be supposed to understand the accepted behavior, so and enhance that standard of data. Okay, now that is about learning element. Next you can see here performance element. What is this performance element? So it is nothing but it will be, so based on the current perception, it will be received from the sensors, whatever the data that is received from the sensors, which you can see over here. So from that input, it is obtained by the learning element. So that is nothing but performance element. So it is responsible to choose the actions to act upon the external environment, how the data to be processed. Next you can see here problem generator. So based on the new goal, learning by the learning agent, problem generator will suggest new or any alternative action which will be leading to a new instructive understanding nature, right? So that is about learning agent, which you can see how the actions and perceptions will be transformed to the sensors, how the data to be performed. Now moving on to this platforms. What are all different platforms of this artificial intelligence technology? So you can see these are very, I already told you, this is a very huge, very vast technology. So we will be having number of platforms like virtual persistent, personal assistants, natural language processing, deep learning, simulation modeling, machine translation, social network analysis, machine learning, robotics and soft robotics, internet of things, image analytics, graph analytics, audio analytics, visualization. So these are all the different applications, different platforms. Coming to the platforms, what are the different platforms to perform such actions or such data to be processed? So Google AI platform, TensorFlow platform, Microsoft Azure, Rainbird, Infosys NEOM, Wipro Homes, Dialogflow, Premonition, IADSD, MindMel, Maya, KAI, Vitel AI, WIT, Receptivity, Watson Studio, Lumiatia, Infra. So what are all these platforms? I won't discuss all these platforms. Let me only discuss some of the very few important platforms, AI platforms. Coming to Google platform, Google AI platform. What is this platform, Google AI platform? So here comes the features. Cloud-based machine learning platform, which is used for customer sentiment analysis. What do you mean by customer sentiment analysis? We already do some analysis to our data. What do you mean by sentiment analysis over here? So here comes the feedback, whether the analysis is positive or negative. So for suppose if you are taking any feedback of Twitter data, of something like product data. So whether it is positive or negative based on that comment. So we need to analyze whether the sentiment is positive sentiment or negative sentiment. So based on the customer usage, that is to be suggested. So it is customer sentiment analysis. Based on the customer usage, it will be suggesting us. So spam detection, for detection of spam emails, spam letters, such type of in unwanted data, such we can get over this spam detection techniques. Recommendation system, like Netflix, right? So for recommending any system, whatever we are using, it will be suggesting us the related concept, related title, related program, such types. Okay, now in this recommendation system. So sentiment analysis, I have already told you, the sentiment will work on the data to know whether it is positive sentiment or negative. Purchase prediction, to find or to purchase anything, we need to predict the with certain accuracy level that it can be performed over here. So what is so best about this Google AI platform? It is a cloud based machine learning platform which uses the sentiment analysis and used for spam detection techniques. So what are the different benefits which we are gaining by using this platform? So state of the art security system, mainly used for security system to develop how securely our data is being processed. And convenient pricing scheme, within whatever the convenient price we are able to afford, how it's been getting the suggestions, whether we are affordable or not, to which products, to which shopping, online shopping, such techniques we will be used over this Google AI platform. Long-term usage guarantee, so how much long term we can use this guarantee we will be getting in this AI platform. It will be giving us, so these products may along for this much time, like that it will be suggesting us. So it is prediction API can. API is nothing but address peripheral interface. It can integrate with Google App Engine and the RESTful API. So RESTful API, what is it? It is whatever it is available that it will be taking. It will integrate both through libraries for many popular languages such as Python, Java, .NET, R programming. So with this all it can work. Okay, here you can see editor rating and aggregated user rating. So we will be getting these ratings by integrating this Google App Engine and RESTful API. Next comes TensorFlow. It is actually the deep neural networks, neural network library file. So some of the features of this platform TensorFlow are deep flexibility, true portability, connect research in production, auto differentiation, language options, and maximize the performance results. Whatever the performance we are having, we would like to maximize the performance results, and we would like to improve the flexibility, true portability. What is the portability it has been offering? So that are all the features of this TensorFlow. What is so best about this TensorFlow? So deep flexibility, true portability, these are the best features we are having. Connect research and production data. What are the benefits of this TensorFlow platform? So we are able to share benefits of machine learning. It's too fast, so it can access the data very fastly. Cloud TPUs are built to train and run ML models. So through cloud, we can access the data, and it is very easy to access from cloud. Whatever the data we want, we can access very easily from the cloud and work on machine learning models. So TensorFlow was originally developed by the researchers and engineers working on Google Brain team with Google's Machine Learning Intelligence Research Organization for the purposes of conducting machine learning and deep neural networks research. But the system is general enough to be applicable in a wide variety of other domains as well. Here you can see the editor ratings as well as aggregated user ratings, how it's been differentiated. So next comes the Microsoft Azure. So it is used, some of the features are here, there are many features actually. Digital marketing, mobile, e-commerce, LOB applications, SharePoint on Azure, Dynamics on Azure, SAP on Azure. So how it's been, what are these features all? So how it's been improvising, what is so special about this platform? These special features itself develops. So understands that Microsoft Azure is also one of the important platforms, such of the features like DevOps, development and test, monitoring, business intelligence, big data and analytics, data warehouse, business SaaS, SaaS. Do you have idea? SaaS, PaaS. So such platforms we'll be having in clouds, right? So cloud migration, hybrid integration, backup and archive the data, disaster recovery of the data, Internet of Things, digital media, high performance computing, blockchain technology, microservice applications, game developments, mainframe migration. In all these, what we can say, techniques, in all these applications, so Microsoft Azure platform providing all these features which can make many improvements in the technology. So you can see the best of the best features, digital marketing. So how can we perform, what we can say, online trading, marketing, how it's been going on in the in online, that we can get over this Microsoft Azure platform. This is one of the best feature that Microsoft Azure is having. And mobile based data and e-commerce, for all this Microsoft Azure is performing, right? So what are the benefits we are getting with this Microsoft Azure platform is mobile enabled, cloud based data, and it can access the cloud data and supports any operating system of languages, tools and frameworks. So this Microsoft Azure machine learning offers cloud based advanced analytics, which was designed to simplify machine learning for businesses. Business users can model their way with best in class algorithms from Xbox, Bing, R or Python packages, or by dropping in R or Python code. Yes, PaaS in the sense, product as a product, not my, I think it's a platform. Platform as a service, okay. So next is Watson Studio. So some of the features of this platform are, we can see our data, refine our data. It means we can retrieve and as well as redefine our data, whatever data is. Yes, IaaS means infrastructure as a service, very good. Next is continuous learning. So it can be learned continuously in this platform. Tools as whatever we all know, so that tools only will be present in this Watson Studio. What are the so best features of this Watson Studio? So we can see our data, refine our data, and deep learning integration is possible in this platform. Some of the benefits are designed neural architectures using the most popular deep learning frameworks. So spend very less time preparing the whatever the data we are having. So have more time discovering insights using the data refinery. So here comes the Watson Studio is an application powered by IBM that provides the data scientists, developers and subject matter experts with an excellent platform for performing data analysis by accelerating machine learning and deep learning workflows. Here comes the editor rating as well as aggregated ratings, which you can see over here. Yes, Ma Shiva Reddy, you are correct now. PaaS means platform as a service, you are correct. Yes. Now let us conclude the session. Before that, so what we have learned in this session that we will be discussing. First, we have understood, so what is this artificial intelligence technology about? So when it has been started, what is the research work done since 1950s? So what is the work that is been done, how it's been come into the existence, and how it's going to improve in the future? So in future, we can see total AI itself. So total market will be AI. So that importance we are having now. So now whoever is doing the research work in this AI, they will have a very beautiful future. And next, after learning about artificial intelligence, we have moved on to the history of artificial intelligence, followed by types of artificial intelligence. Afterwards, what is an agent, different types of agents. Next, followed by the different platforms. Right, so these are all the concepts we have discussed today in this session. So let me go back to the comment session. Do anyone have doubts, please ping me back in comment session so that I could get back to your questions, whatever you're having. So let us give 2 minutes for this comments. If you are having any questions, please do ask me your questions. I hope everyone is understood the session very clearly about the basic concepts of artificial intelligence, which will change your thought to do work under this technology. So I hope everyone have understood the session. So if any doubts, please do ping me. If possible, we will conduct hands-on sessions also on this session, artificial intelligence. Yes, so now let us move on to the conclusion part. So firstly, I would like to thank convener of the event, Dr. R. Gunasundari ma'am, HOD of BCA, for conducting such events. And we are expecting more such sessions with you, ma'am, with this Karpagam Academy of Higher Education by associating with Pantech e-learning. So notice to all the participants, I would like to notice one thing. If you are really willing to work, develop in your technical skills, it's no longer been late. You are on the very right path. So please ping to Pantech e-learning for new technological knowledge purpose, for any internship, for any webinars, for anything like technical expertises. You can please ping us back to Pantech e-learning, which will always support in research development works in all the technical events. So last but not least, I would like to thank Pantech e-learning platform for giving me such a great opportunity to present this session on artificial intelligence technology, which is actually very, very vast technology, which cannot be completed in a 1 hour session. I hope number of sessions to be conducted on this technology. And I thank each and every participant for making this webinar a very grand successful. Thank you all. And if you like my session, please do like, comment, share and subscribe to Pantech e-learning platform. Thank you all. So you can see here, you can follow us on Instagram, Telegram, YouTube and podcast also. So you can get back to the following numbers, which you can see on the screen now. And before winding up the session, thank you all. Thank you.